Every attempt the Spanish government has used to impede things to happen, they have been demonstrated completely not only useless but counterproductive, he told the BBC in English. Catalan President Carles Puigdemont now plans to address the Catalan Parliament on Tuesday, later than was expected. Both are pro-independence campaigners and the ANC is separate from the Catalan Parliament. The Spanish government refuses to hold negotiations on Catalonia's independence bid. There have been several claims of irregularities. There was violence at polling stations as police, trying to enforce a Spanish court ban on the vote, attempted to seize ballot boxes and disperse voters. Besides the MASO's commanders, the Madrid judge questioned Catalan National Assembly, ANC President Jordi Sanchez, and Omnium cultural head Jordi Guixart. They say 90% voted for independence, but have not published the final results. Spain's Prime Minister Mariano Rajoy is chairing a cabinet meeting to discuss the next moves in the confrontation with Catalonia. Meanwhile, the Catalan chief of police, Josep Lluís Trapero, has appeared before a judge in Madrid on suspicion of sedition against the state. His Mossos d'Esquadra force is accused of failing to protect Spanish national police from protesters ahead of the 1st of October independence referendum. The sedition hearing took place at the National Criminal Court in Madrid. The Spanish government's representative in Catalonia has apologized to those injured during police efforts to stop Sunday's independence referendum. But Enrique Melo blamed the Catalan government for holding an illegal vote. Meanwhile, the government in Madrid has issued a decree making it easier for companies to move their headquarters away from Catalonia. A Catalan minister told the BBC his government would go ahead with an independence debate in Parliament. Parliament will discuss, Parliament will meet, said Catalan Foreign Affairs Chief Raúl Romeva. It is not yet clear what they told the judge. The Guardia Civil submitted an official accusation against the Mossos. Leading newspaper El País says the allegation of sedition is extraordinary in post-Franco democratic Spain. The defendants are accused of failing to help Guardia Civil Police tackle thousands of pro-independence protesters outside the Catalan Economy Department in Barcelona on 20 September. Along with Commander Trapero, another Catalan police officer and two leading independence activists are also being investigated in Madrid. There is speculation that the parliament will declare independence unilaterally, based on last Sunday's disputed vote, which was declared illegal under Spanish law. There have been several claims of irregularities. Hundreds of people were injured during violence at polling stations as police, trying to enforce a Spanish court ban on the vote, attempted to seize ballot boxes and disperse voters. The Spanish government refuses to hold negotiations on Catalonia's independence bid. Spain's constitutional court earlier suspended the parliament session that had been planned for Monday. As recently as August, the Mossos was being widely praised for quickly tackling the Islamist cell that carried out the Barcelona terror attack in that month. Organizers of Sunday's vote put the turnout at 42%, with 2.2 million people taking part. They all left the court after the morning hearing free, without facing any Spanish restrictions. Every attempt the Spanish government has used to impede things to happen, they have been demonstrated completely not only useless but counterproductive, he told the BBC in English. Catalan President Carles Puigdemont now plans to address the Catalan Parliament on Tuesday, later than was expected. Both are pro-independence campaigners and the ANC is separate from the Catalan Parliament. The Spanish government refuses to hold negotiations on Catalonia's independence bid. There have been several claims of irregularities. There was violence at polling stations as police, trying to enforce a Spanish court ban on the vote, attempted to seize ballot boxes and disperse voters. Besides the Mossos commanders, the Madrid judge questioned Catalan National Assembly, ANC President Jordi Sanchez, and Omnium cultural head Jordi Guixart. They say 90% voted for independence, but have not published the final results. Spain's Prime Minister Mariano Rajoy is chairing a cabinet meeting to discuss the next moves in the confrontation with Catalonia. Meanwhile, the Catalan chief of police, Josep Lluís Trapero, has appeared before a judge in Madrid on suspicion of sedition against the state. His Mossos Desquadre force is accused of failing to protect Spanish national police from protesters ahead of the 1st of October independence referendum. The sedition hearing took place at the National Criminal Court in Madrid. The Spanish government's representative in Catalonia has apologized to those injured during police efforts to stop Sunday's independence referendum. But Enrique Melo blamed the Catalan government for holding an illegal vote. Meanwhile, the government in Madrid has issued a decree making it easier for companies to move their headquarters away from Catalonia. A Catalan minister told the BBC his government would go ahead with an independence debate in Parliament. Parliament will discuss, Parliament will meet, said Catalan Foreign Affairs Chief Raúl Romeva. It is not yet clear what they told the judge. The Guardia Civil submitted an official accusation against the Mossos. Leading newspaper El País says the allegation of sedition is extraordinary in post-Franco democratic Spain. The defendants are accused of failing to help Guardia Civil police tackle thousands of pro-independence protesters outside the Catalan Economy Department in Barcelona on 20 September. Along with Commander Trapero, another Catalan police officer and two leading independence activists are also being investigated in Madrid. There is speculation that the parliament will declare independence unilaterally, based on last Sunday's disputed vote, which was declared illegal under Spanish law. There have been several claims of irregularities. Hundreds of people were injured during violence at polling stations as police, trying to enforce a Spanish court ban on the vote, attempted to seize ballot boxes and disperse voters. The Spanish government refuses to hold negotiations on Catalonia's independence bid. Spain's constitutional court earlier suspended the parliament session that had been planned for Monday. As recently as August, the Mossos was being widely praised for quickly tackling the Islamist cell that carried out the Barcelona terror attack in that month. Organizers of Sunday's vote put the turnout at 42%, with 2.2 million people taking part. They all left the court after the morning hearing free, without facing any Spanish restrictions. Every attempt the Spanish government has used to impede things to happen, they have been demonstrated completely not only useless but counterproductive, he told the BBC in English. Catalan President Carles Puigdemont now plans to address the Catalan parliament on Tuesday, later than was expected. Both are pro-independence campaigners and the ANC is separate from the Catalan parliament. The Spanish government refuses to hold negotiations on Catalonia's independence bid. There have been several claims of irregularities. There was violence at polling stations as police, trying to enforce a Spanish court ban on the vote, attempted to seize ballot boxes and disperse voters. Besides the Mossos commanders, the Madrid judge questioned Catalan National Assembly, ANC President Jordi Sanchez, and Òmnium Cultural head Jordi Guixart. They say 90% voted for independence, but have not published the final results. Spain's Prime Minister Mariano Rajoy is chairing a cabinet meeting to discuss the next moves in the confrontation with Catalonia. Meanwhile, the Catalan chief of police, Josep Lluís Trapero, has appeared before a judge in Madrid on suspicion of sedition against the state. His Mossos Desquadre force is accused of failing to protect Spanish national police from protesters ahead of the 1st of October independence referendum. The sedition hearing took place at the National Criminal Court in Madrid. The Spanish government's representative in Catalonia has apologized to those injured during police efforts to stop Sunday's independence referendum. But Enrique Melo blamed the Catalan government for holding an illegal vote. Meanwhile, the government in Madrid has issued a decree making it easier for companies to move their headquarters away from Catalonia. A Catalan minister told the BBC his government would go ahead with an independence debate in Parliament. Parliament will discuss, Parliament will meet, said Catalan Foreign Affairs Chief Raúl Romeva. It is not yet clear what they told the judge. The Guardia Civil submitted an official accusation against the Mossos. Leading newspaper El País says the allegation of sedition is extraordinary in post-Franco democratic Spain. The defendants are accused of failing to help Guardia Civil Police tackle thousands of pro-independence protesters outside the Catalan Economy Department in Barcelona on 20 September. Along with Commander Trapero, another Catalan police officer and two leading independence activists are also being investigated in Madrid. There is speculation that the parliament will declare independence unilaterally, based on last Sunday's disputed vote, which was declared illegal under Spanish law. There have been several claims of irregularities. Hundreds of people were injured during violence at polling stations as police, trying to enforce a Spanish court ban on the vote, attempted to seize ballot boxes and disperse voters. The Spanish government refuses to hold negotiations on Catalonia's independence bid. Spain's constitutional court earlier suspended the parliament session that had been planned for Monday. As recently as August, the Mossos was being widely praised for quickly tackling the Islamist cell that carried out the Barcelona terror attack in that month. Organizers of Sunday's vote put the turnout at 42%, with 2.2 million people taking part. They all left the court after the morning hearing free, without facing any Spanish restrictions.